The function of the valves. Intake valve and exhaust valve used in internal combustion engine are made from different materials to operate under different conditions. We generally use alloy steel for intake valves, as these valves are not exposed to the corrosive action of the hot exhaust gases. Therefore, these valves are capable of longer periods of trouble-free operation. The engine valve, as we can see from these images, is composed mainly by three parts: the head diameter, the stem diameter, and the valve seat. Valve guides are made from gray cast iron alloy. Gray cast iron alloy sarebbero delle leghe di ferro fuso. The structure of valve guides has good wear resistance. Gray cast iron with high phosphorus content gives high wear resistance or corrosion resistance and improved running properties even in poor lubrication conditions. Another very important valve apart from the intake and the exhaust valve is the popped valve, which is the type of valve system used in most piston engines. Used to seal the intake and exhaust ports. For seal we mean sigillare. The valve is usually a flat disc of metal with a long rod known as the valve stem out one end. The stem is used to push down on the valve and open it with a spring, generally used to close it when the stem is not being pushed on. For certain applications the valve stem and disc are made of different steel alloys, or the valve stems may be hollow and filled with sodium to improve heat transport and transfer. The engine normally operates the valves by pushing on the stem with cams and the cam followers. The cams are normally placed on a fixed camshaft, which is then geared to the crankshaft, running at half crankshaft speed in a four-stroke engine. On high-performance engines used in Ferrari cars, the camshaft is movable and the cams have a variable height, so by actually moving the camshaft in relation with the engine, RPM. Also, the valve lift varies. The valve train are the valves which are typically operated by camshaft with a series of cams along its length, each designed to open a valve appropriately for the execution of intake or exhaust strokes. You should remember that we have for the function of the valves varies according to the four-stroke cycle phases. For example, in the intake phase, the intake valve is open and the exhaust valve is closed. In the second and third phase, the valves are both closed, so both of the valves are closed. In the fourth phase, called exhaust, the intake valve is closed. On the contrary, the exhaust valve is open to let out gases or wastes. Another very important function of the valve is connected with a clearance measurement. Valve clearance is measured with a valve closed typically atop dead center of the completion stroke. The tappet, which is punteria, will be resting on the heel of the cam lobe. A filler gauge must pass through the clearance space. The filler gauge should fit in and out with a slight drag. If the filler gauge will not fit in, then the clearance is too small. If the blade of the filler gauge fits in too loose, then the clearance is too big.